Amen. How is the God's anointed now generation doing out there? Amen. Before we even start with our service, what we want to do, we want to welcome you out. And we just want to encourage everybody and give them some time to tune in to our YouTube channel, Victory Outreach Barstow. Maybe for this next couple of minutes, what we can do is we can actually start sharing the link, tag all your friends in and start sharing it. Amen, because we believe that God wants to move tonight and help us so we can get the word of God out there. Because the enemy would love to shut down the church, but how many of us know that? We're in the houses right now. We're going into the homes. Amen. And I know right now on YouTube, we have Jonathan live. He's tuning in. Come on, somebody. Amen. We got Sonia. We got Vix, Queen, and Glover. And on Facebook, we got Ozzy, Rios, Rose, Jose, two Joses. Amen. Amen. We just want to encourage you to share right now. We got Destiny tuning in. We just want to encourage you to drop some comments. And let's believe that God's going to move tonight. Amen. Let's believe that God wants to do something great. So maybe right there, even in your home, grab your mom, grab your little brother, your little sister, your niece, your nephew. You know, bring them all in next to your cell phone. If you're tuning in from your cell phone, bring them all into the living room. And let's set that atmosphere, amen, because God wants to do something special. And we got more people tuning in. Felicia, we got Yesidro tuning in, Brandy tuning in. And Glover said, this is Chris, amen, amen. So it's Chris, amen. We got Vanessa tuning in. It's Victoria. We got Lorene Seat tuning in. Amen. We're excited, and we know God wants to do something special. So once again, just give it like a minute or two more. Start sharing it. Start sharing the link. Flood social media. Let's get the word of God out there. Go ahead and drop a comment. We got Isabel watching. We got Vettel watching, Regina, amen. We got some people tuning in. Go ahead and drop a prayer request right there. We also want to encourage you to follow us on Instagram, VO_gang. Once again, we encourage you to follow our page on Instagram, VO_gang. Go ahead and drop some comments. You got the men's home. Say, what's up, gang? Come on now. Got the men's home in there. If you're in the home, go ahead and shout. Go ahead and give Jesus some praise. Raising up some mighty men of valor in the homes. Amen. Destiny saying, gang, gang. Come on. Shout outs. Amen. So with that being said, Angelina, Mark is a sister tuning in. Amen. There it is. Amen. Third waivers. We got Sonia with the third wave. Rose. Amen. So what we want to do is we just want to get started. But before we even start praise and worship, I know we're promoting it on social media, on Facebook, on Instagram, that we have a special video. So we just want to open up service with a special video. Without further ado, here's a special video.
Wars. Politics.
Fame.
Discrimination.
bigotry,
bombs,
crime,
greed,
incest,
abortion,
rape,
hypocrisy,
drug,
adultery,
talk show,
seduction,
child
murder,
racism,
blood,
teenage pregnancy,
discrimination,
Amen, gang. Are you guys excited for gang night tonight? Come on, right there in your house, let's stand to our feet together because we're going to worship God tonight. Amen? Come on, put those hands together.
Let praise awaken inside of every heart, for He is awesome. Our God is awesome. The ground is shaking as we sing it loud, for He is awesome, our God is awesome. Oh, you are faithful, and you're able to do anything.
So we trust you,
so I trust you, never doubt you, 'cause you hold it all. Every day of my life I'll praise you. Every moment I'll bless your name. You have given me love unfailing. Hey, whoa, hey. Let praise awaken inside of every heart. Your name, you have given me love unfailing. Hey, whoa, hey.
Oh,
every day of my life I'll praise you. Every moment I'll bless your name. You have given me love unfailing.
Worshiping Him right now. So right there where you're at, you can just bow your heads, close your eyes, and we're just going to begin to worship Him. Invite Him into your room, into your car, wherever you're at.
To be with you, to be with you is all I need, 'cause it's your love.
Begin to worship him right there where you're at. Come on, if you want to see him move in your life, he can do just that. Oh, but you just got to worship him. It doesn't matter who's there in your home. It doesn't matter who's watching you. Oh, just begin to worship him. You deserve the glory. Sing day.
Jeremiah 29:11, the word of God says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." So whatever you're going through right now, I suggest you leave it in God's hands. And best believe, He will give you hope and a future. He has plans for your life. Just praise Him where you're at. Father God, take full control. Father, have your way, Father. Have your way with God's anointed now generation, Father. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Right there, right now where you're at, just give Him a hand clap. Don't forget to comment. Put your request. So right now, we're hearing God's anointing now generation. Who's ready to make a crack? We are. So right now, I got some reminders for you guys. And right now, on Tuesday night, you know, this Tuesday at 7 p.m. on Zoom. Don't forget it. Tuesday night on Zoom. We have live groups. I recommend you to jump in it. Check it out. It's like almost we're kicking it. I know you like to kick it. So come chill on Zoom, straight up. Gang girls, I suggest you hit up Sister Raquel for the 411. Also, for the gang warriors, a.k.a. I'm a lifer. Yup. Life group, I'm a lifer. Hit up Edgar for the 411. Yup, yup. And also, too, you know, May 2nd, we have International Gang Service Revive Fires. Tune in. It's going to be live and powerful as well. Yes, yes. And also, hold on. I'm sorry. Give me a second. Hello? No way. No. The new gen? What? Word to the wave. Hold on. I'll let them know. Thank you. So guess what? I just got confirmation that next week, I'm talking about next week, the new gen is going to hit it off with a special. Woo! Come on, new gen with a special. I suggest you don't miss out. You tune in next week, same time at 7 p.m. next Friday. Next Friday. So with that, man, we have, those are all our announcements right here. But before we get started, you know, before I want to introduce somebody very special that God moved in his life. And he's going to bring something that God put in his heart to you. He's a gang warrior, Marcus. Marcus, in Jesus' name.
Everyone's blessed tonight. And before I start, I just want to share just a small little testimony. My name's Marcus. I'm 24 years old. And I was born and raised right here in the city of Barstow. My family was lost. They were broken. My mom was a drug addict for over 20 years. My sisters, my brothers, everyone was lost. But there's one thing that I remember, and it was coming into this church back in 2011. Victory Outreach wasn't even like an official church or anything like that. But I remember when I came, Pastor Abel and Sister Raina opened up the doors to my family, to my sisters, my mom. And let's just say since 2011, I'm still here. I'm still serving. I've been in the home. I've been in the gang. I've been in the worship. I've been, you know, just doing things. But I just believe that God is doing new things in my life, you know. And I want to thank God for the team. I want to thank God for Edgar and for Callie and, you know, for everyone that has given me the privilege and the opportunity to be up here tonight. So I pray that wherever you're at and whatever you're doing, whatever you're going through, whatever you're facing, that the song would just minister to you and that it would challenge you to build a foundation with Jesus, to build a relationship with Him. So tonight I pray that you would open up your hearts, open up your minds, And God, I just pray tonight, God, that you would touch a heart, God. Lord, even if it's just one, God, that you would touch a heart, Lord, and that you would draw them to you tonight, God. Lord, whoever's watching, God, young or old, God, I pray that you, God, would touch, God, them tonight. Lord, we love you, God. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. And be blessed tonight.
You're worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of every praise we could ever breathe. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you, God. And holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you, God. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those my eyes in wonder and
Come on, I want to sing that last part over us one more time. It just goes like this.
I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. I will put my trust in you alone, and I will not be shaken.
Amen. God bless you guys tonight.
God bless you, gang. Come on now. God's anointed now generation. Come on. You're not in this house, but are you in your house? And are you tuning in? Come on. Something special is taking place within God's anointed now generation. Not only I believe Victory Outreach Barstow, but I believe internationally. Come on now. How many of us know we're not just a local church? We're a global church. And God is moving all around the world. And I believe he's calling young people. Not only just young people. I believe he's calling all of us to another level. And you see my brother Marcus, he was able to minister to you through a special song. But I believe that God is calling not just one person to expose their talent and to allow God to move through their life. It says that what man lights a candle, it says in the Bible, it says what man lights a candle then puts it under the lampstand. He says that he puts it on top, that he will shine the whole room. There's no purpose to a light being under something. There's no purpose of a light being blocked. So when you step out and use your talent, God's glory is able to be revealed. Because he's called us to be a purpose generation, a God's anointed now generation. And I feel like I have to share this because there's probably somebody out there maybe a little scared to step out. You see, God will give you confidence. God will give you boldness. I never seen myself preaching behind a pulpit or even doing anything behind a pulpit or in God's house. I was lost for a long time. God pulled me out. He said, I got a purpose for you. No longer are you going to be lost, but you're found and you're chosen and you're called. And I want to let you know you're called and you're chosen, and God has a purpose for you as well. And you can see yourself. Maybe God has called you to write some songs, play some instruments. Maybe you've been putting it off because you don't feel like you can. I want to let you know you can. It says you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. So get excited, gang. Something special is going to take place tonight. You can feel his presence, not only in this house, but I believe you're feeling him right now. Amen. So God bless you. But we don't want to stop worshiping him. There's one way that we can worship God, not only through song, not only through instruments and lifting up our hands. We can worship him in our giving. And that's where we're at right now. We're going to worship God through our giving. God is anointing our generation. Do we know how to give to God? Amen. There's three ways to give I want to share with you. In-person giving. We have our church drop-off days, and that's during our service times. We have our midweek service on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. It's an hour before and an hour after on Wednesdays. And then we got Friday, right, tonight at 7 p.m. we start our service, but an hour afterwards when our service ends, we'll be here ready to receive your tithes and offerings. There'll be a trustee here to receive you on a given person. And also Sundays at 10 a.m., you got an hour before and an hour after. Also, we want to let you know you can give online. Online giving at vobarstow.com. And then there's one special way. You could download the Givelify app. And you can select VO Barstow as my place of worship. And then it's convenient. You can just tap to give. You type in your information one time. And then you just tap it. You put the amount. You tap. That's pretty good right there. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to stress about it. When you got to look, you just press it. Amen. You give unto the God at the press of a button. You could be blessed at a press of a button. Come on now. Like to order pizza at a press of a button, right? Come on. How about giving to God and see what he can give you? Come on. But I want to share a scripture with you. It's found in 2 Corinthians 9:7. It says, each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. What does it mean to be a cheerful giver? What causes cheer? Having the character of Christ. It was pleasing to God to give us Jesus because it brought an abundance to the world. Salvation. He paid a price. He bought us with his son's blood. and gave us an inheritance. He forgave us our sins, all our wrong. So cheerful giver is who we're called to be. He does more than abundantly than what we ask or couldn't even imagine. I believe the gang has something to be grateful for, something to be cheerful for. It's by grace that we are saved, not by works, it says. Come on now. So we all fall short. Maybe you've been falling short in your giving. But I want to challenge you here tonight that God has given you something. He's not only giving you a family that takes care of you. He's not giving only you a house over your head. Come on. Clothes on your back. You don't got to really worry, right? But God is calling us to another level. In Luke 16:10, it says, he who is faithful in what is least is faithful also in much. And he who is unjust in what is least is unjust also in much. In other words, God is saying, hey, you got something in your hand. Don't hold on to it. I've entrusted you with this little bit, but how much more I want to give you? You don't even see it. You can't even comprehend it. He says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no thought has entered into the mind of man, the things that God has prepared for those who love him. See, it's something special when we can give unto God in a love and adoration, when we give cheerfully. You see, we love to wait for Christmas and birthdays, and we're ready to give unto our family members. But how many of us know we wouldn't have our family members if it wasn't for God? We wouldn't have the money or the job if it wasn't for God. What God has given us, it belonged to him from the first place. He created you. And what you got is what he's given you to inherit, because you're part of his family. He's giving you a family just so you can feel his love, so you can feel his security, so you can feel who he is. He's a protector. He's a fortress. He's many things, but he's almighty, and he's on your side. And if God is for us, who could be against us? So as you get tonight, I want to challenge you. Step out of the boat. See, you can walk on water. You're not going to sink. You don't got to worry. Trust in God in this season. God is with you right where you're at, gang. God's with your family. You don't got to worry about it. Yeah. Pull it out and give unto the Lord and see what he has in his hand. He will give you faithful. He will make you faithful over much. How many of us want to see the much? He said from glory to glory. I don't want to get stuck in the valley. I want to go to the mountaintop so I can see the scenic view, so I can see everything that he wants to do, so I can see my family sitting up in church, so I can see my loved ones that are lost to be saved. Come on now. Because he started doing it, but I believe he's the finisher and he's the author of our faith. And I believe he wants to do more within our lives. Come on, let's not hold back from God, because he's not holding back. He never held back from us. He went to that cross and he went all the way. And now we got salvation, and now we're grateful, and now we're cheerful. And I believe we could raise up a cheerful generation. You guys ready to be cheerful as you give? Right where you are, I'm going to go ahead and pray for the offering. God bless you as you give. Father God, we just come before you. We praise you. We love you. We pray you bless the offering here tonight. Bless the tithe, God. Bless your young people. Bless those, God, that are tuning in tonight. God, I pray you allow them to feel your presence right where they're at. Anoint the word. Anoint the messenger. Father, I believe you're going to move in a special way. You can feel it, God. We can anticipate it, God, because you're not holding back, God. You're going to do something special tonight. Again, bless the tithe. Bless the offering. Bless those who give, and bless those who can, God. Provide a portion for them so they can see, God, Lord Jesus, that you're not holding back, that you want to do so much more. In the name of Jesus, have your way here tonight. Amen. God bless you as you give.
Guys are still excited, and man, before we even start the message, what I like to do is I like to prepare our hearts, and man, right there in your home, wherever you may be at, maybe you're watching this live in your car, right, or maybe you're at work, you know, and you're tuned in, you know. Well, I pray that you turn it up a little louder so people around you can hear it. Amen. But right there where you're at in your home, maybe you're surrounded by your loved ones who just encourage you to right now just to remove all distractions and to lift up your hands. Prepare your heart, because I believe God wants to do something special. Maybe if you're standing, I just want to encourage you to stand up. Right there where you're at, let's worship Jesus.
Fill me up, God. Fill me up.
let his spirit right now flood your mind. Let his spirit right now stop filling up your heart. Let his spirit in right now. In the name of Jesus, right now God is breaking down some walls. Right now God is doing something in your life. So I encourage you, let go. Let go. Because God's going to do something tonight. People that even hear this word, let them tune in, God. In the name of Jesus. I know, Lord, you're doing something special right now inside of the homes, God. I know you're removing distraction right now, Lord. I know you're doing something beautiful, God. Maybe there's someone that's tuned in, Lord, that's been struggling, that's been going through some battles, God. But I know, Lord, that you're going to bring healing right now, God. I know, Lord, that you're going to bring that miracle tonight, my God. Maybe they're not even involved in the gang, God. But I still believe, Lord, that their breakthrough is right here, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I place tonight into your hands, God. I place the homes and anybody that's tuned in, Lord, that you're going to do a miracle, God. You're going to do something beautiful, Lord. Something that they never seen before, God. Something that they never expected, God. I pray right now, Lord, that you enter the home, God. Enter our hearts, Lord. In the name of Jesus, God, we give you all the honor, Lord. We give you all the praise, God. Remove distractions, Lord. And bring in freedom right now, God. Into the homes, Lord. Anyone that's tuned in, God, let them feel your spirit right now, Jesus. Let your name glorify, God. Let your name melt their hearts right now, my God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, God, for who you are, Lord. I thank you, God, because you are awesome. You are beautiful, Lord. And I place the service in your hands, my God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Right there in your home, it's okay to shout for Jesus. Come on now. It's okay to get a little loud for Jesus. The Spirit of God is here. And I know the Spirit of God is right there in your home. Don't try to kick him out. Welcome him in. Tell Jesus, we welcome you in our home. In the name of Jesus, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Right there in your home, go ahead and give Jesus a shout. Go ahead and give Jesus some praise. Amen. We're excited to have you guys tuned in tonight. I know we've seen many people that are new into this service. And we just want to thank everybody that's tuned in. Amen. We're getting the word of God out there. Amen. Thank you to the worship team. Awesome. Awesome job. Amen. Assuring the presence of God. But I believe right now that the Spirit of God is right there in your home. Amen. And before I even start with this message, what I want to do is I just want to, maybe you're new tuning in onto our YouTube channel. You know, we just want to welcome you to our God's Anointed Now Generation gang service. Then, and maybe you, if you are new, what you can do is you can actually go to our website, victoryoutreachbarstow.com, and you can contact us and send a message, you know, send your prayer request, you know, because we believe that God wants to move and that God does not just have you tuning in for no reason. Amen. God wants to make you part of this family. And we want you to be part of this family. Amen. But before I start, I first of all want to thank God for my salvation, because he's great. He's awesome. Amen. Ain't nobody else could have done what he did. You know, I was shot out. Come on now. I was just a drug addict. I was a nobody. Amen. And I was empty. I felt ugly inside. And I thank God that he pulled me out of that darkness. You know, when no one else could have done it, he did it. You know, and I'm thankful for that. And I won't stop thanking him. Amen. So every time we open a message, we want to say thanks. Be thankful to Jesus. Be thankful for everybody that invested in our lives, from Pastor Sonny and Sister Julie, you know, the founders of Victory Outreach. Amen. I also want to thank God for our elders, because they've been through war. You know, they've been through war, and they're sticking it out, and they're being the exampleship. Amen. I also want to thank God for our pastor, Pastor Abel and Sister Raina, you know, because they welcomed me into the home, you know, when many other homes were shut down and closed at the moment. You know, Victory Outreach Barstow was open. I just want to thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Sister Raina, you know, for your discipleship and for loving on me and for caring about me. Amen. And I also want to thank God for the gang team. Come on, somebody. You can't do it without the team. You want to give a shout out to the team. And every single person that's tuned in right now, you know, we're blessed to see you tuned in. We're blessed. And I feel like it's very important right now in this season to spread faith. Because how many of us know that the world right now is spreading panic, is spreading fear? But we as a church, we want to spread faith. And I just want to invite you to Mark chapter 5, verse 25. And while you guys get there, I'm going to open up with a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, Lord, and I just pray, God, for this message, Lord, that you remove me, God. Remove any nervousness, remove any distractions, God, and let your Holy Spirit just move with freedom. Let your Holy Spirit just come in and do what you please, my God. In the name of Jesus, amen. I know many are familiar with this story. You can find it in different gospels, but this one stood out to me. In Mark chapter 5, verse 25. And the word of God reads, "And a woman was there who has been subject to bleeding for 12 years. She had suffered a great deal under the care of many doctors and had spent all she had. Yet instead of getting better, she grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in the crowd and touched his coat. Because she thought, if I just touch his clothes, I will be healed. Immediately her bleeding stopped, and she felt in her body that she was free from her suffering. At once Jesus realized that the power has gone out of him. He turned around in the crowd and asked, 'Who touched my clothes?' 'You see the people crowding against you,' his disciples answered. 'And yet you can ask, who touched me?' But Jesus kept looking around to see who had done it. And the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell on his feet, and trembling with fear, told him the whole truth. He said to her, 'Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be free from your suffering.'" Amen. Just to go over it real quick, there was a woman that was subject to bleeding for 12 years, right? And nothing was able to help her. You know, nothing was able to help her, right? She had a problem. But when she went to Jesus, you know, when she went to Jesus just with the touch of his clothes, she was able to get healed, right? And Jesus felt the power leave him, right? He felt the power leave him, and she was in fear at his feet. You know, but one beautiful thing that God did, he showed up, and he showed out. A miracle showed up. And I was doing a study, right? And I'll look at the commentary, and the commentary says, because look what it says about this. Because of the sickness she had, it made her unclean under the law, right? A social and religious problem on top of the physical one. Sometimes this condition starts after puberty. If that was true in her case, given a common age, life expectancy, about 40 years, right? And 12 years she had been ill. She may have spent even half or most of her adult life in this trouble. So she cannot bear children in this state, right? The Jewish often divorced a woman who was incapable of bearing. This woman probably has never been married because of the sickness. And if she was married, the sickness showed up after, right? So she has been, right? It says that she could have been divorced or even remained single. And the society where single, celibate women could not easily earn much income. The illness affected every area of her life. Right? And if this woman touched anyone or anything, right, that person will be considered unclean. They'll be considered unclean for the rest of the day. But because she was considered unclean or anything she touched, this is the part that really stood out to me. She shouldn't even have been around that heavy crowd. So then basically she was an outcast. She wasn't welcome. But this is the thing that I love. When Jesus asked, "Who touched me?" Knowing all this, in the eyes of the public, he would have been considered unclean himself. But Jesus still overlooked all that and brought a miracle to her. And I feel like many of us can relate. Just because it's speaking about a woman, I still feel like many of us can relate. Some gang warriors, some gang girls, amen, and maybe anybody that's tuning in tonight. What is your issue of blood, right? And this issue of blood, right, to many it can be fear. It can be anxiety, maybe suicide, depression, insecurity, maybe hidden sin, right? Drug addiction, or maybe you're at a tug of war, right? But tonight, what I want to do is I want to focus on getting to your miracle. And my first main point is what caused her to get to Jesus. When she heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in the crowd and touched his coat because she thought, if I just touch his clothes, I will be healed. Immediately, her bleeding stopped and she felt in her body that she was freed from her suffering. Now, what caused her to get to Jesus? It was a desperation. Come on. Desperation. She was desperate. Come on now. She was hungry, amen. She needed to make it happen. She was desperate of tired of being sick because she was unclean. You know, she had an issue of blood, right? But I like to look at desperate in the dictionary. It's reckless or dangerous because of loss of hope, or reckless or dangerous because of an urgency. And this woman, right, or this gang girl, right, or this gang warrior, they were reckless in the sense of seeing the importance of feeling the urgency. And you know one thing about a lot of the stories from the Gospels, when people came to Jesus, everything that they have in common, right, is they got their miracle. They got their miracle. And I believe just because it happened in the Bible back then, I believe it can still happen nowadays. You know, maybe you're praying for a miracle. Maybe you're praying for healing. Maybe you're believing for your family. I want to let you know that miracle is going to show up tonight. But you got to believe it. You know, one thing that she was doing, she was willing to go further than the crowd. She was a leader. What drove her to get to her miracle, it wasn't because she followed the crowd or was like the crowd. She heard about Jesus but had a different approach than from the crowd. She had a different approach. And it brought me to this is because I want to look at the crowd, right? Was the crowd desperate? And I like to look at it like this. And the way God showed me, the crowd, in a sense, they had on the surface relationship. It was just an outward appearance. They were just chasing the blessing and not the blesser. They were focused on more what he's able to do than who he was. You know, they're focused on more, like, they wanted to see the miracle, right? They wanted to see the lights. They wanted to see the fame, right? But ignore the importance of who Jesus was. You know, the crowd, just because, it stood out to me, the crowd, they were around because they wanted something for free, right? And how many of us know we have those friends? I know I had those friends that always showed up when you had money, always showed up when you had something, but they never roll up when you're going through your troubles and your trials. Amen. It was on the surface type of relationship. It wasn't deep. You know, another thing about the crowd is that they followed each other. They blend in with one another. And I can just imagine God saying, yeah, I see you. Yeah, you're like the rest of them. But maybe I didn't call you to be like the rest of them. Maybe I didn't call you to be like everyone else. Maybe I called you so you can be like this woman, because this woman was different. This woman had a different spirit inside of her. And sometimes when you're part of the crowd, right, we would love to put limits on God and put him in a box, because we're just on the surface. We're like a one-way street. Just give me, right? And I like to look at her now. I like to look at her, and I look at her like this. She was a crawler. Come on now, she was a crawler. She wasn't like the crowd. Was the crawler desperate? Look, I'm telling you right now, if you're crawling to your location, that's a sign of desperation. That's a sign that you need that, that there's an urgency inside of your heart, that you want that. And I like the definition that the Bible gave: heartfelt, sincere, and deep affections. Because she came to God on her knees, right? And when you're on your knees, you ain't afraid to get dirty. You know how the dirt looks because you're on your knees, right? Not just that. When you're on your knees, you know, when you're praying, right? When you're praying, you're reading your word, you're sacrificing, you're putting everything on the line. That means you know how to put in work. Come on now, that means you know how to put in work for Jesus. When you wake up in the morning, right, maybe God wakes you up at 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning, praying for someone that you haven't even met yet, right? When Jesus is putting someone in your heart, maybe to send them a scripture, maybe to sacrifice your flesh for a minute just so they can receive a breakthrough. Where you're able to push back darkness away from the people that you're working with. Where you're able to pray and intercede for them. Where you're not too sophisticated, right, to reach the streets or the hopeless. Where we don't get to a point in life where we're just, hey, I'm good now. Where we can know how to still stay in the gutters and go and reach the lost souls, the people that are hurting. When you're on your knees, you're not afraid to get dirty, right? Where them demons should know who you are. Where them demons, right, should know you, because you're putting in work for Jesus. Because you're the one that's sacrificing everything, right? When the demons see you, they should be like, hey, here comes the gang ministry. I know when the gang ministry comes around, I know when these young adults come around and these young people come around, they start taking souls away from us. Hell starts depopulating, and heaven starts getting populated even more, right? The demons should know who you are, because you're on your knees, you're putting in work. Or you're putting in work, right? You're telling people, hey, join us on YouTube. Hey, join us on Facebook. Hey, follow us on Instagram. Hey, we got something special for you. Hey, we're doing a giveaway, right? Where maybe we're not able to be out there in the streets physically, but we are targeting the social media right now. We're believing that even right there in your home, you're still able to get a breakthrough. Right, this type of relationship, a crawler, right, where she knew how to go deeper. She knew how to go deep. She was willing to go deep. She didn't care if she looked foolish. Oh, come on. She didn't care how she looked when she raises her hand. It didn't matter to her how she would look when she starts lifting up her hands, when it comes to worship, when she starts shouting and jumping because of the Holy Spirit that's in the room. Where she wouldn't care if she looked foolish, right? Because she's posting up Jesus on her social media instead of just selfies. Come on now. She's flooding social media, right, with Jesus. When you're going deeper, you know you need Jesus. Come on now. When you're going deeper, you know you need Jesus. Doesn't matter how high in leadership people can get. You know you need Jesus. Because maybe the crowd was there for the hype, right? Maybe the crowd just wanted to be seen with Jesus, right? But she knew she needed a breakthrough. She knew she needed some rest from all the years that she's been struggling, that she's been facing, that she's been oppressed, that maybe there was a generational curse. Right? Maybe she knew all this. She's like, no, look. For the crowd, that's cool. You can get seen. You can get seen with Jesus. But for me, I know I'm messed up. I know I'm all jacked up. I know I need Jesus inside of my life. So as a matter of fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get on my knees. As a matter of fact, this crowd, these people don't even want me around. But I'm going to go a little deeper. I'm going to dig a little deeper. I'm going to spend a little longer time in prayer, whatever it takes, because I need that miracle inside of my work, inside of my home. I need Jesus to show up. That's what she was doing. She had a different class of mindset. She looked at it different from the crowd. She went where no one else wanted to go. While the rest of the crowd was on their feet, she was on her knees. She was different. She had a different pair of eyes. Well, she looked through the eyes of faith. And I like to look at this because the crowd and the people didn't want her around. But she was like, look, I'm going to look foolish right now. I'm going to maybe look dumb to the whole world right now. But I'm going to get close to Jesus. Maybe I'm going to lose some friends in the process. Maybe I'm going to lose some close ones in the process. But guess what? They're not even good for my spiritual health. So guess what? Maybe God's just pushing them out, and I'm getting closer to Him. So guess what? I can lose those friends because I know if I pray for them, I know if I believe for them, I know if I fast for them, they're going to come and they're going to surrender their life to God. Right? She didn't care how she looked. She said, I'm going to jump. I'm going to shout. I'm going to get radical for Jesus. Maybe the world may try to silence me. Maybe the demons in my head may try to quiet me, but I'm not. As a matter of fact, I'm going to get a little more passionate about God. I'm going to dig a little deeper for more for God. She had a different mindset. She had a different mindset. She looked through the filter of God. The world looked at her like, look, man, you're jacked up. Stay over there, please. She was like, nah, I see God. That's my breakthrough. That's my miracle. And I'm going to get to it. Everybody else, you can try to stop me. But watch me get desperate tonight for Jesus. Amen. And I like to look at this because I can imagine when she was back there, you know, she was struggling, right? She was battling. How many of us go through the struggles, the voices in our head? We have fear kicking in. We have fear talking. We have faith talking, right? Well, what voice drove her to the miracle, right? Fear would love to tell you, would have told her, right, to look at the crowd around him. Look, there's no way you're going to be able to get through. There's no way. This is fear. Look, you're not going to be able to get through Jesus. Look, you see that big crowd? There's no way. There's no way you're going to be able to do it, right? But I know in Joshua chapter 1, verse 9, it says, I have not commanded you. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. I know that she had this type of mindset. Sometimes fear will do whatever it takes. Sometimes fear, right, will do that to make you think that that can't happen. Hey, you're praying for your family. Guess what? That's not going to happen. Hey, you're believing for the future, for your calling. That's not going to happen, right? This is fear. We'd love to do that. Everyone would look at you weird, right? That you're not normal. This woman knew. She knew she wasn't normal. She knew she needed Jesus. And the fear will. If she would have never reached her miracle, if she would have listened to the voice of fear, fear would have failed her. Maybe we feel that sometimes from our past failures, right? Or we failed one time, and we don't feel like we're strong enough to get back up and to go at it again. Fear would love to break you. And I like to look at this because fear was a gripping emotion. It would love to hold you. It would love to not allow you to move. It would love to keep you paralyzed. But I love this woman. You know why? Because she didn't listen to fear. She was like, "Nah, I'm straight. I see fear coming. Watch out, move. Get out the way. I'm getting my breakthrough tonight. Amen." Now, faith. Now you have faith, right? When you put desperation and faith together, it creates a miracle. This is what you're able to see through this story. It created a miracle for her. And in James chapter 2, verse 14, I'm going to start on 18. But someone will say, "You have faith and I have works. Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. You believe that there is one God, you do well. Even the demons believe and tremble. But do you want to know, oh foolish man, faith without works is dead." And I love this, right? Because I can just imagine her and I can picture it. She was battling. She was at a tug of war, right? We got faith and fear whispering in your ear, right? Guess what faith was telling her? Faith was whispering in her ear, "Hey, I need you to go. Hey, maybe the crowd don't want you. But that doesn't matter right now, because there's a miracle. You need to seize this moment. As a matter of fact, I need you to go over there. I need you to get your breakthrough, because no one's going to get it for you right now. I need you to spend a little time more in prayer. I need you to spend more time with your disciples. I need you to do these things, because I need you to get desperate. I need you to be different from the crowd." Well, she knew how to dig. She knew how to work hard. She jumped right into it. She said, "Hey, look, I see Jesus walking by, and that's my moment. Maybe I'm not allowed to be around him, but guess what? I'm going to slide right through, and I'm going to break through the crowd, and I'm going to receive my miracle, because I know, because faith is allowing me to see it before it happens. So I'm already seeing my miracle. I'm already seeing my family saved. I'm already seeing the loved ones that I'm praying for healed already. I'm already seeing this gang ministry blow up. I'm already seeing this. I'm already seeing millions of people tuning in, talking about Jesus. I'm already seeing social media flooded with God." Faith is already allowing us to see it. It was dope, right? Because faith gave her permission. Come on. Give her permission. Man, don't listen to fear. Come on. Just go for it. I need you to get close to Jesus. Amen. I know at times it can get a little difficult to see it before it happens. But you know one thing about people with faith is they're willing to step into new territory. Oh, this was a battle for her. This was a struggle for her. But she said, "Nah, this is my breakthrough. This is my miracle. And I'm stepping into this territory. And I'm walking out healed. And I'm not going to be suffering no more." And if I can call the worship team up. Faith is a releasing emotion, right? And I like to look at this. verse 30 of that same story. At once, Jesus realized that the power has gone out from him. He turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who touched my clothes?" "You see the people crowding against you," his disciples answered, "and yet you ask me, who touched me?" But Jesus kept looking around. Then the woman, knowing that what had happened, her came and fell to his feet, trembling with fear, told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be free from your suffering." I love this, right? Because Jesus realized that power has gone out from him. Jesus felt her. You know why? Because she was seeking him different. Jesus felt her. He said, "Look, I got a whole crowd around me. But someone creeped in and didn't even touch me, touched my clothes. It touched my clothes. But I felt them. Why? It's because they were denying their flesh. Come on now. They were denying maybe the wrong influence. They were denying depression. Maybe they were seeking God when times get rough and difficult. They weren't giving up, right? This is what she was doing. He said, "Hey, I felt something." His disciples are, no. "Hey, basically, hey, God, you're tripping." He's like, "No, someone, I felt them. I know there's a ganger out there that's getting a hold of God. I know there's a gang warrior out there that's getting a hold of God like this. I know there's someone that's tuning in. Maybe you're from a different city, but this is how you're getting a hold of God, where you're different from the crowd, where you're not satisfied to be the same like the rest. Because God didn't call us to be like the rest. God called us to be different." And just because she went where nowhere else wanted to go, right? I like to look at it like this. And I feel like it's important, and I felt this in my heart, to express it like this, to show you, not just to say it, to show you what the issue of blood can look like, right? For many years, right? I like to look at it like this. Right? For many years, this was the issue of blood. She's been holding on to this for too long. Way too long. It said 12 years that she was holding on to this. It was unclean. Everything in the trash is unclean. But she was holding on to it. You know, this was having her. This was gripped onto her life. And she tried everything. As a matter of fact, what she did was this. She said, "Hey, I'm going to go to the doctors and I'm going to stuff it in there. Hey, I'm going to try my friends and I'm going to try to do that. And I'm going to spend some money. As a matter of fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to invest everything that I got into this. I'm going to do it off my own will. No counseling. No nothing. Nothing in life was able to help her. Nothing in life was able to help this woman. You know the only thing that was able to help her? As a matter of fact, I'm going to tell you like this. When she did go to the counseling and the doctors and everything else, guess what happened? It grew worse. Come on. It grew worse. Look what happened now. It grew worse. You know, her doubt, her fear started kicking in. It started gripping onto her. But you know what happened? When Jesus showed up, she was desperate. When Jesus rolled up to the scene, he said, "Hey, there's a breakthrough for someone out there tonight. And I believe God's doing that tonight. Maybe you've been battling, you've been struggling with fear, with doubt, with suicide. But I want to let you know that tonight, God's going to bring a miracle to your home. Tonight, God's going to do something beautiful." It was a small bag, right? It was a small issue of blood. But when she trusted in people, and when she gave it to people and everything else, you know what happened? It grew bigger. She tried every avenue, and it just got worse. And you know what God was saying? "Hey, look, You have to let go of the old to receive what's new. And look what happened. She received her freedom. She received peace immediately. It wasn't no 7 days waiting list. Come on now. It wasn't hey, you order it now, we're going to ship it to you later. It wasn't like that. Her miracle showed up there on the spot. Right there on the spot. If you have doubt right now in your heart, remove it. If you have fear gripping your heart, let it go. Because God wants to do something. As a matter of fact, I want you to step up right now. I want you to get up right there wherever you're at, in your home, in your work, maybe in your car. I dare you to step out your car. I dare you to lift up your hands. Because I know Jesus has a miracle for you. And I feel like it's all to God now. If you feel like this message spoke to you in any kind of way, maybe you're barely tuning in. Guess what? Let go. And let God do that miracle tonight. Right there where you're at. Just let it be you and Jesus tonight. While the worship sings, just let it be you and God. Stop trying every other resource and avenue and give Jesus a shot. Give Jesus a shot. Give him a shot. I thank God because I can imagine the type of mindset she had. She said, hey, in Luke chapter 5, verse 31, it is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. She was probably like, thank you, Jesus, because I know I need you. As a matter of fact, look, crowd, get out the way. Move, get out the way. I need to get low. I need to get desperate because I know that if I just touch his clothes, just a touch, I know if I just touch his clothes, it's a wrap. I can tell that suffering. I can tell depression. I can tell suicide to get out of my home, to get out of my life because that's no longer me. The moment I touched, I became his daughter. I became his son. All Jesus wants to do is give you freedom for the exchange of our trash. We have to let go of what's old to get what's new. I'm gonna let the worship sing. And like I said, it's just you and Jesus. Just you and God. I believe God's doing something right now in some homes. open your heart, open your mind, because God's healing someone right now. We don't need to be right here physically in church to receive a miracle. God is knocking on your door right now. You hear a knock, that's Jesus. You hear a knock, that's God. And he has a miracle for you. He has a healing for you tonight. It don't matter how old you are, how young you are, how far you feel away from God, how much of an outcast you feel, God's healing someone tonight. We don't need to physically touch you. God's able to do it. There's a miracle right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. Right there where you're at, in your home. I just want you to repeat this prayer after me. Bow your head. And if you're next to someone, grab their hand and say the prayer together. Just repeat this prayer after me. Say, Father God, I admit I am a sinner. And I believe you died on the cross for me. Rose on the third day, and I confess you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, come into my life and take full control. Father God, we come before you right now, Lord, and I pray, God, that everyone that's tuned in, Lord, I know there's a miracle, God. I know there's a miracle that just showed up. I know there's a healing right now. I know there's a prophecy that just rolled up on them. So I place the word in their hearts, God, and let your name get glorified, God. Let our hearts melt for you, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, take full control, my God. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Right there in your home, wherever you're at, go ahead, man. Give your neighbor a hug. Come on out. Go ahead and shout. Give Jesus some praise. Amen. You don't want to miss out. Next Friday, we'll be having a special talk show. My testimony. Amen. You don't want to miss out. Tuesday nights, we have live groups for the Gang Girls Connect with Cali, for the Gang Warriors Connect with myself. With that being said, we just want to bless you. Good night. Like I said, drop a prayer request on the comments, an emoji. Amen. Thumbs up. Claps. Amen. Drop something. Amen. God bless you.